Hey guys, welcome to Intellipaat. Since Java has been around for more than two decades, that might be one of the reasons for why it has become a go-to programming language when it comes to choosing the Android development. But ever since Google announced Kotlin as the official programming language for the Android development at Google, wannabe Android developers or even professional Android developers are in a constant dilemma of choosing between Java and Kotlin. And this debate of Java versus Kotlin has been long overdue. So keeping that in mind, we'll talk about the same, that is the Java versus Kotlin. So guys, before we proceed forward, do subscribe to Intellipaat's YouTube channel so that you never miss out on our next upcoming videos. So let us start off by looking at the agenda for this video. First and foremost, we'll start the session by getting a proper introduction to both Java and Kotlin. And after that, we'll discuss all the parameters on the basis of which we'll make the comparison on Java and Kotlin. We'll also have a look at the percentage switching from Java to Kotlin and vice versa. Then, we'll also look into the job trends in both the technologies. And then finally, we'll conclude the session by deciding which one is better, Java or Kotlin. And guys, we'll also have a short quiz based on the video. Make sure to put down your answers in the comment section below. And if you're looking for the courses in the trending technologies, do visit Intellipaat.com. So guys, without any further ado, let's get started.
So guys, let us first understand what exactly is Java. We all know that Java is one of the widely used programming languages expressly designed for use in the distributed environment of the internet. It is high-level programming language which are interpreted by JVM. Java also supports multi-platform and can run on different platforms including Macintosh, Windows, and Unix computers. Now let us move forward and discuss about the Kotlin, right? So Kotlin was developed in 2011 by the programmers of a software development company called JetBrains in Russia and was then augmented by several open source developers, and Kotlin gives developers the features they ask for actually. So Kotlin is a general purpose, open source, statistically typed, pragmatic, or we can say practical rather than theoretical programming language for the JVM and Android that combines object-oriented and functional programming features. Now we'll see some of the pros and cons of the both languages. So let's move forward. So guys, first and foremost, we'll discuss about Java. After that, we'll see that what Kotlin has. Alright, so pros of Java. There are many advantages of Java that clearly represents its recognition among the developers, community and enterprises, right? Now we will see one by one what makes us fascinated to learn Java. So it is easy to understand and learn. Alright, and also it is easier to execute which run code in a browser or in a virtual machine. It provides open source platform and up-to-date information and feature-rich programming language, and it has the ability to assemble the large projects precisely with the help of modern tools. Alright, and it also helps in wide community support that keeps Java up-to-date. And we are all aware that it is owned by Oracle Corporation, who is dedicated to making it stronger, right? Android itself depends upon Java language, and also there is a flexibility for cross-platform app development. It also guarantees the automatic and effective memory management, which makes it portable to use on a range of devices from large networks to the lowest PCs. Alright, so guys, let us move forward and discuss the cons of Java. So some of the cons that makes Java not a prominent language for developing, they are, so Java is slow. Java is comparatively slower than the other languages. So one of the problem of Java, which always, you know, annoys a programmer. So this is one of the biggest drawback of Java programming language. So Java makes memory space, than it takes more memory space than the other native programming languages like C and C++. This problem hasn't been overcome by the Java developer as of now. So language limited latency, critical tuning. If you have to spare every second, then Java is not the best choice, and instead use some other language in such scenarios, right? So Java's architecture code is inefficient. So guys, Java's ability for producing portable architecturally code is desirable. The method used to create this code is inefficient, right? So last but not the least, it doesn't guarantee the backup. So there is no backup. It is mainly for storage and less efficient for data backup. So Java loses its value and prestige in such cases, guys. So this is also drawback that affects Java's rating. All right, so let's move forward. So guys, basically it seems like Kotlin has become loved by many developers, or I would say mobile developers. Here's a list of Kotlin's most prominent benefits. All right, so it increases team efficiency. Being rather than clear and compact, the language allows increasing the efficiency. more work can be done as it takes less time and write and few lines to write and deploy working code, right? So guys, next is it compiles with existing Java code. So Kotlin is positioned as a 100% Java interoperable programming language. It is consistent with Java and all related tools and frameworks, which makes it possible to switch to Kotlin step by step, right? So, and it is also easily maintainable. It is easily maintainable because Kotlin is supported by a vast majority of IDEs, including Android Studio and other SDK tools, right? And guys, this helps in increasing the developers' productivity as they can continue to work with the toolkit they are used to, isn't it? So everyone looks for less bugs, right? Here's our last but not the least advantage, that is the Kotlin is less buggy. So Kotlin offers a much more clear and compact code base that makes the code in production more stable and consistent. Bugs get detected at compile time, so developers can fix errors before runtime. Isn't that cool, right? So guys, we have discussed about the advantages of Kotlin. Now we are moving forward with its drawbacks. So first and foremost is that they have limited learning resources as it is a small and a new community, which was originated in 2011. Makes sense, right? So therefore, there are only a few experienced people to ask and a few tools to use to pick up some tricks. So it may become a challenge to switch from Java to Kotlin from your team. So finding Kotlin developers seems difficult than Java developers. So sometimes compilation is slower as compared to Java. All right, so now we'll discuss the major differences between both of them. So no doubt Java ranks as one of the most widely used programming language. Java was being developed in actually 1991 and it was relatively new programming language. At that time, James Gosling from Sun's Microsystem and his team began designing the first version of Java aimed at programming home appliances, which are controlled by a variety of, you know, computer processors. And in 1994, he realized that such a language would be ideal for use with web browsers, and Java's connection to the internet began, right? So Java was launched in 23 January 1996, which was initially developed by James Gosling at Sun's Microsystem, which is now a subsidiary of Oracle Corporation and was being released in 1995. So now moving on to Kotlin. So before 2017, Android app developers almost exclusively used the Java 6 programming languages. All right, with support for their later edition, Java 6 was introduced in 2006, 2 years before the release of Android devices. All right, in 2011, the company introduced the Kotlin language, but few Android developers started using it. Although Kotlin was production ready, the language was not stable. At Google I/O 2017, Google announced that Android will support Kotlin as a first-class programming language from now on, which was then launched in 2017. All right, so Kotlin is a statistically tied modern programming language that runs on a Java virtual machine by compiling Kotlin code into Java bytecode. It can also be compiled to JavaScript source code. Isn't that interesting, guys? So now moving forward towards the compilation speed for Java and Kotlin. So as Java is a verbose language, right? You need to write a lengthy code that usually contains error, right? And bugs also. So it's that simple. Kotlin uses developer-friendly coding structures and norms that are easy to understand and use. In case of longer code compilation, Kotlin is preferred over Java. So guys, this seems quite obvious when you have a larger application or a bunch of files to be executed, right? So Java is somewhat less considered in terms of speed. So moving forward is based on the lines of code. So coming to the lines of code compared to Java, Kotlin has less lines of code, which makes it safe, concise with a lean text. All right, so Kotlin also offers null safety where it avoids null pointed exception. If you try to assign or return null to a variable or function respectively, then it won't compile. So guys, now let us consider the example of a hello world code, right? So in case of Java, if you see on your screen, this is the code for Java, right? But in case of Kotlin, if you will see, the code goes like this. So when you consider the above example from developer's perspective, you will be able to understand why Kotlin is loved by developers around the world. It is concise, effective, and faster compared to Java. Moreover, there will be less chance of errors and bugs and resulting in cost and time reduction, right? So guys, let us move forward and discuss about the lean syntax and concise, and in other word, I would say interoperability. So interoperability is Kotlin's core purpose. From the beginning, the project's intention has been to use existing knowledge and expertise to make every library available to Kotlin programmers. So developers can simply write modules in Kotlin that work flawlessly with existing Java code. by emitting the bytecode. A Kotlin compiler allows the two languages to work in unison in the same project. All right. So one-liner functions take one line, or simple structs or Java beans can also be declared in one line. So real properties generate getters and setters behind the scenes for Java interoperability. And adding the data annotation to a class triggers auto generations of boilerplate like equals, hash code, two strings, and much more. Now moving forward, in terms of Android, we all know that Java is an object-oriented programming language developed by the CERN Microsystems, right? So which is right now owned by Oracle. So being such an old language, Java does a whole lot more than just developing Android app. So if you know Java, you have a lot more job opportunities. You may not want to develop only Android apps all the time, so Java lets you spread your wings wider. But if it is specifically about Android app development, so Java is being considered as the most promising language for that. So guys, in case of Kotlin, the Kotlin mobile app development community is continuing to grow, and it is right now growing rapidly, guys. So back in 2017, Google acknowledged Kotlin by making the second official language for Android app development. So since then, the programming language has seen a monumental rise in demand in both the developer and enterprise community. So with Google announcing that Kotlin is now its preferred language for Android app developers, the language is proving to be a pragmatic, modern, and initiative programming language. So guys, with the Google announcement, Kotlin is now its preferred language for Android app developers. The language is proving to be a pragmatic, modern, and initiative programming language. So guys, now let us move forward and discuss about the percentage switching. So Kotlin requires approximately 20% less coding as compared to Java. Right, so Java will remain essential for Android app development. And switching the entire team to Kotlin at a time can be a bit of a shock. So it is important to do this transition slowly, one person at a time. Having said that, Kotlin is new official language, and owing to its modern nature, it will become widely adopted in the future. Alright, so learning it and starting development with it right now would be a good idea. Though Java will continue to be a popular language for a long time and isn't likely to be entirely replaced, so take your time and make the switch gently. Because at the end of the day, it's all about what you feel comfortable with, right? So to be a true Androidian, you must have a proficient knowledge, or I would say a proficiency in hands-on with Java Android development. All right. So now let us move forward and discuss about the job trends of Java and Kotlin. So guys, there are like tremendous amount of job opportunities in both Java and Kotlin. But if we really compare between both of them, of course, Java is something I would say is universally accepted, right? And Kotlin has just been introduced into the market like 7 years ago, and no doubt its market is increasing, but still Java remains the royalty of languages. Even though there is a slight decrease in the overall trend to learn the language, since people are mostly moving towards new programming languages like Python, Go and Kotlin, which comes under that category, isn't it? According to Gartner, trends ranking Kotlin is nowhere to be seen. While the popularity of programming language index shows that Kotlin as one of the fastest growing languages, there is a clear discrepancy between what employers require versus what developers want to learn, isn't it? So when it comes to growing trends like Java and Kotlin, I would suggest that we do not take either of the rankings for granted, but rather use them as complementary to each other if we are to picture a more accurate image of the most popular languages out there, right? And guys, in order to check the job opportunities in both of these languages, let us move forward and see in our indeed.com that what are the job postings over there. So guys, when we go to indeed.com and see for the job postings for Java as well as for Kotlin, you would realize that here are like salary estimate and the job postings, right? So if you would see that job type and for the full-time opportunities, there are like these amount of job opportunities in Java. All right, in case of location as well, there are like these amount of job opportunities in Java, right? And the companies, they're like Fortune 500 companies hiring for Java developer or Java Android developer, right? So this is in case of USA. And in case of Kotlin, in USA itself, you would see that there are very less amount of job opportunities in Kotlin. And no doubt it is increasing widely, isn't it? You would see the amount of salary they are giving to people are quite decent. Or even if we say the contract type of job opportunities, in case of location, see the job opportunities are very less. But of course, they are growing rapidly. The amount of job trends that we have seen across the globe, even if in Google Trends or any other way around, the graph is actually growing rapidly. So in case of India, guys, you would see that there are like many salary estimates. And the job openings are like huge, isn't it? So full-time job opportunities, and even in case of location, they're like 16,000 Bengaluru, and Hyderabad that is like 5,000, and goes on. There are like so many cities out there. And in case of companies, Fortune 500 companies are itself hiring for Java developer. Now let's move forward and discuss about Kotlin job opportunities in India. So salary estimates, you would see little lesser than what we expected actually. All right, so the job opportunities are lesser, but mind you guys, the amount of job opportunities opening in India for Kotlin are quite higher as compared to USA or any other country. All right, so this was all about the job trends in Java and Kotlin in both the location USA and your India. All right, now moving forward to what should I choose, Java or Kotlin? So now everyone has a confusion whether to go with Java or Kotlin. So guys, here is the answer. Kotlin's documentation is very well implemented. If you look at the advantages of Kotlin app development, it is much better than Java on topics such as security, syntax, compatibility, and functional programming. Therefore, we can say that in this context, Kotlin is better than Java. However, we know that the occupation of Java since a long time, and out of 100 job postings, almost 90 job postings would be of Java itself, and 10 would be of Kotlin. I'm not saying that Kotlin does not have a chance to be a champion here, but it is right now evolving and is being adapted by many companies rapidly. But again, in compared to Java, it is nowhere close. So although Java is starting to add some functional programming elements, but at its core, Java is still a procedural language. And yeah, Java has various scope of opportunities in various fields like Big Data, Hadoop, MapReduce, and Spark, and many more. Kotlin, on the other hand, has just been introduced into the market, right? So its other scope of approaches are yet to be discovered apart from the Android development. However, its approach in data science is right now being experimented, and there is no doubt it can give a tougher competition to data science oriented languages such as Python and R. And guys, there are many other programming languages that you might have considered. They are actually designed to run on the Java virtual machine. Although there are many languages that can compile Java bytecode, but there are few specialties of Kotlin that make it way better than the other in terms of null safety, which I mentioned before. So the point is, choosing any of these languages would be of higher relevance for you. However, Java is still a master here due to its current occupation in the market. So everyone has a doubt that we should learn Java before Kotlin. No, there is no need to master Java before you begin learning Kotlin. But currently being able to convert between two is still a requirement for effective development, because Kotlin simply makes your life easier as a Java developer, right? So now you guys tell me, according to you, which one is better, Java or Kotlin? We would gladly accept your responses. So guys, this brings us to the end of the session. Now I have a question for you. Here on your screen, there are two codes for Hello World, and which one of these code is related to Kotlin? The first one or the second one? Do let us know your answer in the comment section below.
So guys, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you have any further queries, comment down below. We'll reach out to you immediately. Thank you so much for giving us your precious time. See you again.